गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द डिस्कशन ऑफ सोलार थर्मल एनर्जी। दिस इज़ द कंटेंट विच आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस। फर्स्ट, सोलार थर्मल एनर्जी, सोलार थर्मल कलेक्टर्स, टाइप्स ऑफ सोलार थर्मल पावर प्लांट इन विच देर आर फोर टाइप्स: पैराबोलिक ट्रफ सिस्टम, सोलार पावर टावर सिस्टम, सोलार डिश और पैराबोलिक डिश एंड स्टर्लिंग इंजन, लीनियर फ्रेजनल रिफ्लेक्टर, सोलार चिमनी, ओशियन थर्मल एनर्जी कन्वर्जन, एप्लीकेशंस, एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस, सिनेरियो इन इंडिया। सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम व्हाट इज सोलार थर्मल पावर प्लांट। सोलार थर्मल पावर जनरेशन सिस्टम विच यूजेस द मिरर्स टू कलेक्ट द सनलाइट एंड प्रोड्यूस द स्टीम बाय सोलार हीट टू ड्राइव द टर्बाइन फॉर जनरेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। This for uses in industry, residential and commercial sectors. There are four major functions which is almost same in all type of thermal plants: is solar radiation collection, then concentration to the target, conversion of heat, storage of energy, generation of electricity. Solar thermal collector. There are two categories: one is concentrating solar thermal and other is non-concentrating solar thermal. Concentrating solar thermal divided into the three categories: non-tracking means simply capture the solar radiation and focus onto the receiver. In this example is compound parabolic collector. Single axis tracking, in this the panel is rotates on one axis moving back and front direction. Only there are different types of the single axis trackers, include the horizontal, vertical, tilted, which rotates as the name implies, and this the example contains the linear Fresnel collector and the parabolic trough collector. Dual axis tracking system, to track the sun into the two directions, elevation and azimuth. Dual axis tracking prototype is developed to capture the maximum sun's radiation by tracking all four possible directions: left, right, front, back. Examples are parabolic dish reflector, heliostat field collector. Second type is non-concentrating thermal power plant. Simply, this is the solar radiation which is parallel to the flat plate collector, absorbs the heat. Further divided into the three types: solar pond, flat plate collector and evacuated tube. Types of the solar thermal power plant. On the basis of the focusing, there are four different plant. First is line focus. It is actual practicing the line is a collector pipe from where the working fluid flows to transport the heat. The parabolic trough system and linear Fresnel reflector is working on this method. Second one is point focus. In this, the point is a small vessel where through which the fluid flows to transport the heat. In this category, solar tower and the parabolic dish system works. Now, under the type of the solar thermal system, first is parabolic trough system. It is single axis tracker and the line focus system. The sun's radiation incident on the parabolic trough consists of a linear parabolic reflector that concentrates the light onto a receiver position along the reflector's focal line. Working fluid passes through the receiver and becomes very hot to passes through the steam generator, hence converts the steam, the highly generated steams then further to transport to drive the turbine, where about one third of the heat is converted into the electricity. Third is solar power tower system. This is the picture of solar power tower system where the thousands of tracking mirrors are kept in array 2 meter square. Here is the picture shown the working procedure of the power tower system. Power tower, also known as the central tower plant or the heliostat. In this, the array of mirror is used to focus the sun's radiation onto a receiver tower that superheated containing the molten salt. The heated salt is pumped through a steam generator, then the steam drives a turbine to generate the electricity. the cool salt is collected and then sent through the system back again so that the cycle can repeat it. Next is solar dish or parabolic dish. It is a dual axis tracking system and point focus. The system consists of a lone parabolic reflector that concentrates the light onto a receiver position at reflector's focal point. The working fluid in receiver, which is heated up to the 250 to 700 degrees Celsius, the receiver is Stirling engine can generate the power. So what is the Stirling engine? It is a device that converts the heat energy to mechanical power by alternatively compressing and expanding a fixed quantity of working fluid. Main parts here is two, power piston and displacer. Power piston, it is a small and tightly scaled piston that moves up when the gas inside the engine is expand. And displacer, it is a large piston and very loose in cylinder so that the air can move easily between the heated cool section of the engine as the displacer move up and down. About working, one side of the piston is continuously heated and other side is continuously cooled. First, air is moved to the hot side where it is heated and expand the gas pushing up piston. Then the air moves through the generator to the cool side where it's cool off, contrasting pulling down the piston. Like this Stirling engine works. Here's the picture shown the alpha Stirling engine and beta Stirling engine. Fourth type is linear Fresnel reflector. It is similar to the power tower, but here uses a series of ground based flat curved mirror to focus the sunlight onto a fixed absorber, which is located several meters above the mirror field. It is single axis tracking and line focusing system. The absorber consisting long selectively coated tube flowing water is heated and goes through this steam generator to further allow to drive the turbine to produce the electricity. Here in this picture shows the absorber tube, and this is a secondary reflector mirror is placed to the refocusing of sun's radiation onto the absorber so that the more water can heat it. Characteristic of solar thermal electricity system in this table shows the good differentiate between the parabolic roof power tower and the dish engine or Stirling engine about size, temperature, operating efficiency and cost. Here we can see that the more temperature required for the dish or the Stirling engine rather than these two. Efficiency of power tower is much higher than the parabolic dish or the steam Stirling engine. In the parabolic trough, limited availability of the storage. Next topic is solar chimney. The main parts of the chimney is collector, turbine and mirror. Chimney itself, the collector, it's usually the uses to produce the hot air by the greenhouse effect. The mirrors are 5 to 6 meter above, covers the large area and made up of glass or the thin film or the glaze collector. Usually it is made up of glaze collector because it converts the 70% of the sun's radiation into the heat. The turbine, hot air is heated by the sunlight turns to the turbine to generate electricity. Turbine is placed horizontally in the chimney so that the maximum amount of the energy can extract. Third is chimney. Chimney is the most important. It is acts as a thermal engine. Longer the chimney's height, more energy can produces. Efficiency is mainly depend on the ratio of the height and the outside of the temperature. Next topic is ocean thermal energy conversion. It is a process of producing the energy by the temperature difference between the ocean surface and the water and the deep cold water, and the temperature difference is 20 degrees Celsius. About working procedure, due to the solar radiation falls on the ocean surface, water becomes warm, and this warm surface water is pumped through an evaporation containing the working fluid. The vaporized fluid is derived to turbine generate the electricity. The lower pressure vapor turns back to liquid in condenser cooled with ocean cold water pump from the deeper in the ocean. Working fluid is liquid ammonia which leaves back to the evaporation using pump, hence the cycle is repeated. These are some applications of the solar thermal plants in which the water heating, parabolic solar cooking and pool heating consist. Advantages and disadvantages. Advantages are no fuel required, so no cost. Solar thermal energy can generate power 24 hours a day. No pollution and global warming effects, CO2 free. Using existing industrial base, since the solar equipments like mirrors, turbines, which large scale at low cost by existing only for industrial base. Easy energy storage. Energy stores uses the molten salt, can use at the night time also. Disadvantages. Initial build cost is high. Ecological and cultural issue. Means the usage of the large area for the mirror, which can impact the wildlife in the desert area. Limited location and size. These plants can located where the high amount of radiation falls, like desert, not possible in populated area. Water issue. Solar thermal uses the lots of water is the major issue in the desert area. Photovoltaic can built in residential area, but the solar thermal can't be installed in residential area because it requires the large area. Build time would be longer than the other type of the energy generation. So these are the disadvantages. Scenario in India. India's largest thermal power plant in Madhya Pradesh, Vindhyanchal Power Plant, produces the 4,760 megawatt of electricity. India won this project is based on in-house developed 60 meter square parabolic dishes used, generating the electricity in Rajasthan. Here is a list of the solar thermal power plant in India, mostly the parabolic trough technology uses. The very first ever project is Godavari Solar Project in Rajasthan, which is estimating the 50 megawatt of electricity. In Gujarat One Solar estimating the 1100 megawatts of electricity. And Dosa Power Plant in Rajasthan using the linear Fresnel reflector estimating the 125 megawatt of electricity. So these are some solar thermal power plants in India which is listed. There are more power plants. Solar thermal power plant potential. Geographically, the solar energy potential, because the area data close to the equator having the higher amount of the solar radiation. However, the use of the photovoltaic can follow the solar position, significantly increase the solar potential in area that are farther from the equator. So comparably low power generation cost can be achieved wherever insulation reaches up to 900 kilowatt hour per square meter and year or more. Here the picture shows the orange area. Orange shade shows that there are more solar thermal power plant than the yellowish area. So yeah, absolutely a bright idea for human welfare. Solar is throughout the renewable form of energy which can never get out of stock. It is difficult to destroy or create, but transfer from one to another form is possible throughout adoption of various process. Thank you.